At ease, it's your boy Soul Immortal. You know, I made video after video on the topic of marriage, right? But people are still asking me why I disagree with legal marriage. And the thing is this, it's not that I disagree with legal marriage, it's just that I think that women have evolved past the point of legal marriage, right? In most situations, you know? Because you have to be honest with yourself. I don't care if you want to talk about love and commitment and all that stuff. Marriage, in the legal sense, is nothing but a business decision between two people. You know what I'm saying? It has absolutely nothing to do with love, right? So you asked, like, are there any situations or scenarios where I think that legal marriage makes sense, right? And the thing is this, even though I personally feel like any two people can come together in any situation and be loving and committed forever without any involvement of Big Brother, even though I believe that, I do see two scenarios where marriage makes sense, right? So if you take a young man, this first scenario, right? Let's take a young man, he's ambitious. He wants to have a woman in his life. He wants to have kids. He wants to have, you know, the house, the picket fence, that type scenario. And he sees a woman and he goes to this woman and lets her know that he wants her to be a part of his life, you know. He wants to have kids, he wants to have a family, he wants the house taken care of. And the woman, in her mind, she's saying, okay, well, I'm ambitious too. You know, I wanted to be a doctor or a dentist or a counselor or whatever. Like, I had dreams too, but I love you and I believe in your dream. Let's come together and let's become one, right? Now, in that situation, I think, you know, knowing that marriage is strictly meant for the security of a person, mainly women, or the redistribution of assets if the merger goes wrong, in that situation, it makes sense to me. It makes sense to me. Because in that scenario, if a woman forfeits her goals, becomes a man's, you know, wife, and this man goes on to do great things, in the event that merger goes south, that woman deserves a part of that kingdom because she's been the half of that kingdom that's operating the back half. I get that. I've never been against that. Yes, it's hard when I see celebrities getting divorced and seeing that some man has to give his wife, you know, $50 billion or whatever. Am I sour about that? But that should put more importance on us men of who you're getting married to, you know what I'm saying? Or what you're actually doing, understanding what marriage is, right? So in that situation, I get it. I understand it. It makes sense, right? On the opposite end of the spectrum, if I look at like a Jay-Z and Beyonce, I can even see in that situation where it makes sense, right? But because you have two people that have decided, you know, to do big things in life. They come together, they love each other. Love has nothing to do with the marriage. But then they say, you know what? You know, let's build our kingdom together. You know, we're making millions of dollars together. We're on tour. It's all going to one basket. We have children now. So let's make a full effective merger out of this deal, right? Because if anything goes south, you know, we're making money so fast, we'll just need this thing split down the middle because we don't know who's actually bringing in what, right? So in that case, it makes sense, right? But what we're dealing with today is the hybrid woman, right? And the hybrid woman is a woman that's straddling the fence, right? You know, one leg is in the, you know, I want to be a supporting cast. I want to be a wife. I want to be submissive. I want to do all this stuff that the wife A did, right? But I want to get that bag at the same time, right? Now, the thing is this. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. You know, that's what most women are in today's society. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. My thing is this. My thing is I don't understand how you can talk about marriage and this hybrid woman in the same sentence. And I'll tell you why, right? But because, like I said, this hybrid woman, she straddles the fence. On one end of the spectrum, You know, she still wants that manly man. I want a man to take care of me. I want a man to hold me down. I want him to do man responsibilities. I want him to pay the bills. I want him to do all the things that man is supposed to do. But at the same time, I want to be a bad chick. I want to get that bag. I want to build my empire, right? So that's where the confusion comes in with me. So when you hear me talking about why, you know, when I don't agree with marriage, this is what I'm talking about, right? So in a nutshell, when I'm talking about marriage, when I'm talking about the hybrid woman of today, right? It's not me saying I'm against marriage. Again, it's me saying that today's women have outgrown legal marriage, right? But because really what they've done is they've been able to check all boxes. On one hand, they have a man that's giving them the love and checking all the boxes of whatever a man is in their life. And two, they've been able to build their own security, right? So to discuss marriage and the hybrid woman is almost like it's just pointless, right? But what you've also seen in today's hybrid woman is due to the fact that she's straddling the fence, it makes her, you know, a trick of both trades, but a master of none. So that's one of the things that we see with this hybrid woman. You know, she's trying to do both or play both sides of the court, but being able, you know, but trying to spread that energy in two different directions, you know, it really makes a lot of these women just, you know, like I say, you know, they're a trick of all trades, but a master of none. Eddie!